Graffiti is the oldest art form known to man. Some of the oldest graffiti can be found in the western caves of France. Other styles of graffiti were later seen in ancient Egypt. The ancient Egyptians used these hieroglyphics to tell their story and also to record their history and customs. After Egyptian hieroglyphics, many forms of art became popular in the world, such as the Renaissance, the Neoclassic, and Romantic periods. As we see these art forms become more popular, we see graffiti fade away. But then, in the 1920s and 30s, we see a resurgence of graffiti on the streets of Los Angeles. This graffiti was used by local street gangs to mark their territory within their communities. One of the most common street gangs to use graffiti was the Mexican Mafia, or MS-13. Graffiti's popularity then traveled to the East Coast cities like Philadelphia and New York City, where the pioneers of modern graffiti art, such as Cornbread and Stay High 149, began to make a name for themselves on the streets by hitting up everything from buildings to subway cars and freight trains all over the two cities during the 1960s and 70s. My nigga need a sweater tougher than leather. Swing another Rodney King thing and I wreck. But just like the white one, I get no respect. Money stay awake, cause the other. During this time, these artists used their graffiti to express themselves and to let others know that they were there in otherwise forgotten communities in both major cities. The reason why these artists painted on trains was because they knew that their name would be carried across the city, or in some cases, even across the state. In the documentary, Vomit, they also said this.
Ugly condition, and they're not doing nothing. I'll give you something to do. Right. Get up. Bomb. That's why they say bomb the system.
You do away with all the things that you're subjected to, everyday life, and to go on route, it's like just say, fuck everything else. I'm going to do my thing.
To really reach out, say, look, I'm here.
I exist.
This is me. Hello, world. I'm fucking here.
You put a pen in any child's head, naturally, they'll go to the wall.
Some of the common equipment used by graffiti artists are masks, used to hide their faces from cameras. While some artists use their masks to define them, like Banksy, others use typical respirators, ski masks, or bandanas to hide their faces. Next, any artist could not do anything without his paintbrush. Most graffiti artists use spray paint. These artists will usually use bright and metallic colors to have their piece stand out from its surroundings. Taggers will also use specialized tips to help them create a certain style in their art. For quick tags, artists will use paint pens such as Crinks or Decos. And for more permanent tags, artists will use shoe polish. Also, taggers will usually wear gloves so that they don't have any incriminating evidence like paint on their hands if the cops start to chase them and they have to dip out. Another very important item that all graffiti artists have are sketchbooks, aka piece books, where they can practice new designs before they take it to the streets. Most of the language used in the graffiti art culture stems from the early hip-hop culture of the 1980s. This is because most of the people who were writing came from low-income ethnic areas of Philadelphia and New York City, such as West Philadelphia and the Bronx. Some of the hip-hop groups that heavily influenced the language of this culture are Run-DMC, N.W.A., and the Beastie Boys. Some of the phrases used by this culture are fresh, fly, dope, to diss, and to front. There are many unique phrases used by the graffiti culture. Some of these phrases are bombing, a kill, burn, king, all city, up, a toy, biting, and buffing. Just like every culture, Graffiti artists have a set of rules. While these rules are unwritten, those who do not abide by them are labeled as toys. There are some places where you should never tag. Those places are houses of worship, houses, cars, and schools. You're never supposed to tag in these areas because then the public sees this as senseless vandalism instead of an actual art form. Another unwritten rule of the graffiti community is that you never buff, paint over, or cross out another writer's piece out of respect for the others around you. By doing this, you can start a tagging war. One of the most famous wars was between Banksy and King Wabo under a canal bridge in England. Banksy started the war by painting over a 25-year-old piece done by King Wabo, which was highly disrespectful. And this is how it all started.
This piece, painted in 1985, underneath the British Transport Police headquarters on a barely accessible spot of Regent's Canal, it stood largely untouched, becoming the oldest piece of graffiti in London and a testament to Robbo's legendary status. Even in retirement, Robbo was revered by new writers coming onto the scene. But then one night, he met a young artist from Bristol called Banksy.
So I was in a place called the Dragon Bar down Old Street. I was introduced to a couple of guys and they was like, well, it's such an honour to meet you and stuff, you know, and I was paying respect. When I was introduced to Banksy, I went, oh yeah, I've heard of you, mate, how you doing? And he went, well, I've not heard of you. Whenever I met someone, whether I heard of them or not, I always said I did hear of them. I never put no one down. And he dismissed me as a nobody, a nothing. So with that, I slapped him. I went, what, you ain't heard of me? But you won't forget me now, will ya? And with that, he picked up his glasses and he ran off.
Other basic rules of tagging are to never tag your name or your crew's name on either your backpack or your binder, so the police cannot connect you to any tags done on the street. Lastly, you should never own up to your tags publicly or on any social media site like MySpace or Facebook, because you can get caught by the cops. Graffiti artists have many common behaviors. Usually, they always tag at night. Also, many taggers go out with a crew to limit the possibility of getting caught by the police. Unfortunately, you don't always get away with it, so there will be many times when you get arrested. Conflict perspective is one of the key factors of this subculture, because it creates inequalities in many ways. For one, graffiti artists are barely seen as real artists because of the nature of their work being illegal, which causes there to be a rift between them and real artists. Secondly, graffiti artists create inequalities amongst themselves with their own hierarchy. At the top, there are kings like Robbo, to all city artists, then regular writers like Talkie183. And lastly, toys, such as new artists and young teens. The only way to rise in the ranks is to get more respect by bombing all over the city with your new and personal creative style. There are three main styles of graffiti: tags, throw-ups, and wild style. The basic tag is a quick signature with your name and usually the number of your street, done in only one color. And then you have throw-ups, which are a series of bubble letters done in two different colors. Lastly, there's wild style, which looks like illegible 3D letters composed of many different colors. As you can see, the subculture of graffiti art has a history as old as time, but with new equipment, rules, and styles,